is ready. Well, the question is, are the Saints? We'll preview Sunday's battle with Sterling Sharpe and the Packers. We'll go in depth with two tight ends, rookie Irv Smith and veteran Hoby Brenner.
I think you'd have to rate him number one.
We'll review Draft 93 with analyst Mike Detillier. And those rookies get together for this year's Saints Sideline poster, The Wild Wild West. But this turns into this. We'll show you the Saintsations trading card.
Touchdown, New Orleans Saints. You bet.
And dances with the Cardinals. The Saints are heard in the Navajo Nation. Make the big commitment to Saints Sideline. Next.
This is Saints Sideline.
Hello, and thanks for joining us on Saints Sideline. I'm Ed Daniel.
I'm Alexander Levine. Ed, thank goodness, the off weeks are over. Now they can get knuckled down and get ready to play some ball.
Sound like you really missed the NFL variety of local football this week, right?
I'm looking forward to the Packers game.
Boy, I tell you what, it really sounds like it. Sounds like it was a sad weekend at your home. Wasn't that bad, though. The Saints are looking forward to Green Bay. And, of course, then they'll play that big Monday nighter in San Francisco against the 49ers. Clearly, the next 2 weeks will set the tone for the rest of the season. The Green Bay Packers spent a wheelbarrow of cash in the offseason on those free agents, most notably Reggie White. And they're beginning now to play up to expectations. Doug Mouton previews Sunday's big game.
Green Bay's Brett Favre is probably the most excitable quarterback in the NFL. Some people say that's a bad thing. His coach doesn't think so.
He just gets excited when he plays, which is good. That's a good thing. You know, I mean, I don't want him out there yawning, you know.
Boring, he isn't. His primary target is Sterling Sharpe. If number 84 isn't the best receiver in football, then there are only a couple better. He's got it all. Size, speed, strength, great hands. You've got to stop him to stop the Packers.
Statistically, last year, you know, if you're going based upon last year, you'd have to say that you'd have to stop Sterling Sharpe, because I believe he had over 100 catches, and the next guy had like 30, and that might have been a running back, you know. So with those disproportionate numbers, I think you have to focus on him.
On the other side of the ball, the Saints have to stop this guy, free agent zillionaire Reggie White.
And I think, guys are making plays, everybody's making plays, and I think everybody's getting a feel of what needs to be done to win.
The task of stopping White falls on rookie William Roaf, who White praised after their preseason game.
Reggie's the type of guy during the game that just gets stronger as the game goes. I mean, he can beat you in a number of ways. He can beat you upfield. He can use his power and strength, or he can just, you know, run right over you if he wants to. But I think the thing about Reggie that makes him great is that as the game goes on, he gets stronger, you know. He doesn't get weaker. He gets stronger as he picks up. So he's the type of player you have to play for four whole quarters. You know, he's never going to take a throw.
The Packers are good and getting better. How the Saints play Sunday will tell a lot about the rest of the season. I'm Doug Mouton for Saints Sideline.
Despite playing in the same conference, Sunday's game between the Saints and the Packers will be their first regular season meeting this decade.
The last time the Saints and the Packers played was back in 1989 at Lambeau Field in Green Bay. Bobby Hebert had a huge day. Here he hits Lonzel Hill for the score. Hebert threw for 282 yards, and the Saints had a 24-7 halftime lead. In the third quarter, Don Majkowski hit Ed West to get Green Bay to within 24-21 and set up a wild fourth quarter.
Play fake. Well thrown ball.
Hebert hits Mo Hill again, and the Saints are back up by 10. Then, Majkowski hits a wide open West, and it's 31-28.
Touchdown, Green Bay!
After a Morton Anderson field goal put the Saints up by 6, Majkowski hits rookie Sterling Sharpe with the game winner. The Packers won a thriller, 35-34. The Saints will try to get some revenge Sunday. The two teams did meet in the preseason. Mike Buck got the start and had a bad day. Buck was just 4-for-13. Corey Harris got this interception, and the Packers built a 17-0 lead. D- Derrick Brown then turned in this spectacular 35-yard touchdown run, and the Saints were back to within 17-14 at halftime. The second half was all Saints. Ronaldo Turnbull sacks Ken O'Brien for the safety, and the Saints won 26-17. They'll try to repeat that performance Sunday.
Coming up, we'll go one-on-one with tight ends Hoby Brenner and Irv Smith.
And we'll unveil this year's Saints Sideline poster, The Wild, Wild West, next on Saints Sideline.
Until this past April, the Saints had never used a first-round draft choice on a tight end. Of course, they did that this year, taking Notre Dame's Irv Smith. Smith spent the first half of his rookie season learning from 13-year veteran Hoby Brenner.
2 weeks in October again taught the Saints just how cruel the NFL can be. Pittsburgh's Carnell Lake taught Irv Smith to protect the football, just one of the lessons the Notre Dame rookie received in on-the-job training.
There's a lot of things that I haven't done quite as well as I like to in all the games thus far. And you know when you make mistakes, you just have to realize that it's not the first mistake that you've ever made, and it's not going to be the last mistake that you ever will make. And because of that, I just realized that, hey, you have to go on. Next week's another week. Get back to work and get yourself better.
In Phoenix, 2 weeks later, Smith got another dose of disappointment. Wade Wilson found the rook down the middle. Smith dropped the ball. Setbacks, true. But long term, the prognosis for Irv Smith is good.
I think Irv's going to have a heck of a career.
The same can already be said for Hoby Brenner, who survived 13 years in the NFL on good blocking and smarts. The old veteran is a communicator. He chatters on the line of scrimmage with tackles Richard Cooper and another rookie, William Roaf.
College players, per se, they don't do a lot of communicating online. And so that's a big hurdle to overcome for younger guys who's trying to get the lines of communication open. They don't want the other player to hear them talk, but it's better that you both know what you're doing than just one of you.
You know, an NFL experience is everything. I think when you look around and you see veterans that are good players, but they're great players because of what they know, things that they can do out on the field, not just physically, but mentally, it makes a world of difference.
As Smith gets that, he'll get more of this. Irv Smith is the tight end Hoby Brenner never could be. Translation, Irv can think and run fast. Hoby, well, he'll have to settle for just being smart.
He's obviously the fastest tight end we have, I would say.
Irv Smith and four other Saints rookies are featured on this year's Saints Sideline poster. Welcome to the Wild Wild West.
Since the Saints Sideline Wild Wild West poster had a Western theme, we had to find a location that had horses and an old rustic barn. We found both at the Ponderosa Stables in St. Rose, Louisiana. Next, the clothing. They had to look the part. Trusclair's Costume Supplies gave this posse from New Orleans an intimidating Western look. With the exception of Lorenzo Neal, this is the closest these guys have ever been to a horse. So they spent some time getting familiar with what was going to be, at least for the next few hours, the best friend. Now, it was a matter of positioning the players and their horses into place. And then to capture the moment, photographer Bernardo Wade.
Derek, I like that, Derek. Hold that, babe. Everybody, lean forward. Look, that's it. That's the shot. Hold that. Good.
How's it feel to be a cowboy?
It feels kind of weird. That horse is jumping on me and scared me a little bit, but it was okay. I think the shoot worked out all right, but I was a little scared then when that horse started backing up on me.
Big guy like you and that horse scared you?
Yeah, that horse scared me. I grew up in Pine Bluff, but I never rode around horses a lot, so, you know, yeah, it scared me.
How'd it feel to be a cowboy for a day?
Oh, it's fine, you know. Now I know how the guys in Dallas feel.
Tell me, what does it feel like being out here, Roy?
So great. Remind me of California. Remind me out on the farm. Waking up early in the morning, getting on my horse and riding a couple miles.
Irv, you look pretty good up there. It looked like you were getting in the groove.
It was my first time riding on a horse in my life. I had some good training by one of the brothers out here. I think I can hold my own there.
It looked like you had a little bit of an attitude up there. Is that the...
That was the whole purpose, man, you know, because we coming from a long way out in the western fields, you know, coming home.
Mr. Potter,
How do these guys look as cowboys? What kind of cowboys do these guys make?
Some rough and tough looking cowboys.
You think they fit the part?
Yes, they do very well.
And Fast Eddie, here is a look at the Wild Wild West poster. Take a look at it. Looks good.
Looks awfully nice. Was your idea?
Yeah.
Oh, man. These posters are available beginning Wednesday at all Supercuts locations. They are free with a shampoo and a haircut.
Coming up next, more on the Saints rookie class. We'll talk to draft analyst Mike Detillier.
Plus, Saintsation trading cards. Alex has all of them when Saints Sideline continues. Saints draft is shaping up to be one of the best in team history. How good was it? Doug Mouton asked draft analyst Mike Detillier.
Down in Raceland, Mike Detillier is busy preparing for the 1994 draft. When April comes around, the Saints will try to repeat their performance of 93.
How did the Saints rate in this draft with the quality people they got compared to everybody else in the NFL?
I think that you'd have to rate them number one. No one else has gotten productivity from that many rookies. So you'd have to rate him as the best draft if you're looking at it right now.
Detillier's been especially impressed with William Roaf, who he calls a Rookie of the Year candidate. Here's Detillier's opinions on the Saints' top five.
I thought he was the best offensive tackle to come out of college since Richard Webb came out in 1990. And he's done everything. He's far exceeded what I thought he would do. Smith has been a little bit of a disappointment. But I think he's going to come around. He's going to be an excellent player. But right now, I think he's lost a little confidence catching the football. He is getting open, though, and that's important. But he's going to give him a dimension down the field as a tight end they haven't had before. A lot better than I thought. Just a real bowling ball runner and just great balance and leverage. He's going to be an excellent player. Great instinct, yet he finds the open hole. And, you know, he would have been a senior at Nebraska today. And, you know, that's amazing that he's come in and played so well. He's exactly what I thought. Speed, punt returner, got excellent hands, and he's an impact player.
Three other picks, seventh rounder Othello Henderson, sixth rounder Ronnie Dixon, and this guy, second rounder Reggie Freeman, are also on the roster. Seven picks out of eight didn't just make the cut, they're making an impact.
Is it safe to say that looking at it now, this is going to be one of the best Saints drafts, one of the two or three best in history?
I don't think there's any question about it. 81 certainly sticks out because you still have guys that are playing and starting from that 81 squad with Ricky Jackson, Wilkes, Brenner, Warren. But this is going to be an outstanding draft.
Only time will tell just how good this draft was. I'm Doug Mouton for Saints Sideline.
Those rookies have all become subjects of their first NFL football cards this fall. The card business is booming, and not just for the players. The Saintsations dance team also have their own set of cards.
We love our trading cards. They're wonderful. I think it's good because, you know, game day, we don't have a number on us. We don't have our name on us. Our name isn't, you know, announced over the loudspeaker. So I think the trading cards kind of give the public a way of knowing us as an individual.
The children like to collect them because they like to trade them and exchange. And I think the families like to show them off and say, this is my daughter, or this is my friend. And so it's a good way for them to pass them around so everyone can get to know the girls better.
It's funny because most people who don't even know me in school, that, and you know, UNO is pretty big, and they come up to me and they're like, oh, I think, because I'm on the back of the display, so they, you know, they see me outside of the card, and they say, oh, I think I saw you at the gas station, you know, and I'm like, yeah, that's me, you know, and it's kind of, I don't really know what to say, because it's kind of, they put you on the spot, and they'll start saying something, and I'm like, let me guess, you saw me on the cards, you know, and it's just, it's weird, I don't know.
Coming up, Buford Jordan will join us to look ahead to Brett Favre and the Packers. That's next on Saints Sideline.
Among the best in the NFL. Pro Football Weekly ranked all 28 teams in their midseason report. Here's what they're saying. The top six teams are, number one, the Dallas Cowboys. Number two, the Miami Dolphins. That's how the newspaper sees the Super Bowl stacking up. The top challengers, number three, the Buffalo Bills, and the 49ers are fourth. The New York Giants are fifth. The Saints are ranked sixth, saying, surprises. The performances of Wade Wilson and Derrick Brown. When these guys have played well, the Saints have won. Disappointment, Jim Dombrowski. It's not that starting left guard Chris Port has been a sensation. Dombrowski just isn't playing well. January forecast, the Saints are in a fight with the 49ers for the division title, but they still must prove they can finally win a playoff game.
That stigma is going to stick with the Saints until they get that first playoff win. For our midseason report card, we go on the bench with Buford Jordan. Buford, you saw the top six. The Saints are listed as third in the NFC behind Dallas and the Giants. If I had the rate, I might say maybe Dallas and San Francisco, and then maybe the Giants and Saints, right?
Yeah, really, I would, too. You know, the thing is, the Saints had strong performances early in the first five games that really has carried over for the last three. So, you know, the way people are playing now, I'd say Dallas and Frisco are playing real good ball at this point.
The Packers are listed as 14th in the poll. Is Green Bay a legitimate contender?
I think they are. You know, I mean, they have the defense, man, especially with Tony Bennett coming back. That's going to really help Reggie White out, you know, and take a lot more pressure off him. So I look for the defense to move up in the rankings. And the offense, you know, they're okay. You know, their real weapon is Sterling Sharpe, you know, that you have to really watch out. Brett Favre does a good job, you know, of running the offense and getting the ball to him.
Buford, your prediction could drive the line up or down 4 or 5 points. I know the whole world's waiting to hear about it. Will the Saints win? Will they cover?
I think so, you know, because the key to this game is going to definitely be the offense. Our offense is going to definitely have to perform, you know, to beat them, because I think, like we said, the defense has one key to stop, and that'll be, you know, Sterling Sharpe.
Up next. The Saints break another language barrier as we continue on Saints Sideline.
DMI New Orleans, the official travel company of the New Orleans Saints. Call the company the Pros Call, 592-0500.
All Saints games are broadcast on the radio in both English and Spanish. But last week in Phoenix, the Saints were heard in another language. Northern Arizona football fans were treated to the Saints and the Cardinals in Navajo.
All right, first down, 10 ball on the 15-yard line. New Orleans Saints, Joseph Gaby, Adonat 8, Adonat 8, now. Wade Wilson, what are you going to do? Joseph Gaby, it's St. Augustine, the end of the Joseph Gaby, a smash. Go on in, they got the Patrice, Joseph Gaby, Adonat 8, Adonat 8,
Adonat 8,
and Cardinals, touchdown.
There it is.
Residents of the reservation proper are pretty big sports enthusiasts, so anytime you get a, the station had an opportunity to be involved with sports, the people went crazy.
With 200,000 listeners on or around the Navajo Reservation, KTNN Radio is a major player on the Arizona sports scene. The language itself has caused some unique problems.
The Navajo language is a very lyrical language. It's not a very literal language, so there are a lot of words that we use in English that do not exist, even if the feelings or the thoughts don't exist in the Navajo consciousness. So you have to make up, put together words.
In fact, the Saints could only be referred to as the Saints because there is no concept of a saint in the Navajo language.
I could deny, yeah, I can't unbelievable. Michael D. Moore, to this car, another way to preach, and then he got a touchdown, New Orleans Saints. You bet.
Alex Morton Anderson, of course, does the Super Bowl every year in Danish. for a television broadcast in Denmark. We understand he wants to renegotiate his contract. Meanwhile, back here in New Orleans, we do high school football in English and for a lot less money, and it's playoff time. Don't miss all the highlights of round one on Friday Night Football. That's Friday at 10:30 right here on WGNO 26.
The Saints and the Packers kickoff is at noon on Sunday. Vince Buck spent the off week getting married. We'll leave you with a look at the Bucks special day. I'm Alexander LeRon.
He won't be getting any time soon. And I'm Ed Daniels. We'll see you next week after the Packer game on Saints Sideline.
Good night.